you're fine.
3, 2, 1, go!
All right, we're moving on to a never set with PS2, and surprisingly, wait, who's okay? Jen is going Rosalina. I guess this is pick against the Palutena. Ditto. Oh, okay. It looked like the face. Okay, I was thinking the face cam's wrong. So, okay, that makes a bit more sense. Actually, yeah, I do remember seeing Utopian use Rosa a bit, like at waypoint a few times. Last time I was there, anyways. So yeah, okay, I can see that. So I guess hey, this is his answer against the Palo Ditto. And not Banjo, surprisingly, because I know he's been using him a lot more secondary alongside Palutena. Okay, covering that with the grab. And I love the movement on that, with the fact that she was covering the ledge and outside the ledge constantly. Oh my god, Luma just took so many hits, dude. She's dead. Luma is freaking dead, man. Oh, okay, but Jet's gonna push her out quite far. There is no edge guard quite yet, but it was smart on Utopian to try and cover her with the up air, but there was still a missability of her holding on ledge anyways. Sour up air, not going to come from into much, but it's going to get some more damage. It's definitely in the lead, but that was a cute platform cancel. Ledge cancel, I mean to say. Speaking of cute, that nair into up tilt. Like, I don't understand how that works, but he just keeps getting it, man. It's so cool to see. I guess it's cool for me anyways because of the fact that it's just a new thing that I've never seen for Palutena before. I guess, like, it's weird to say, can you fit Palutena and Kuma in the same sentence? Sometimes, maybe? I'm not quite sure. Can you say Luma killing you from jab is cool? I also don't know. It's subjective. This whole game's subjective, if you want to think of it like that. Oh, and covering the nair both on and off stage. That was clean. And, like, the amazing reaction time from Jen, knowing how to react to certain get-up options. Just neutral get-up. Just gonna get vibe checked with the shield, bro. Nice dash attack. Oh, and she's just pushing him off stage so effectively, and she just won't let him get back on. Oh, but a poor time down there will allow her to get back on the ledge and back on stage. And plus, neutral has been reset, and now Jen is surprisingly on the ledge. And plus, now we're back in the middle. Hot potato with the ledge guards currently. Okay, a bit too much aggressiveness on the nairs, and Bus got punished for it with the back air. And again, up tilt, I'm not even gonna keep talking about this move. This move is just neat. It's pretty neat. I'm still new to this in terms of Palutena up tilt. I'm being slowly revelated to how good this move secretly is. Okay, there's a back throw. Just gonna get some stage presence, but she gets back on for free, surprisingly. But a poor honor article is going to get punched with a bit of damage from that forward throw. More pummels, an up throw, up air. Just some clean bread and butter combos. Oh, calling out the air dodge. Clean stuff from Utopian. Ah, a bit too soon on the... what I assume would be trying to get a read anyways. Is it a read if you try to get the read, but nothing happens? I don't know, honestly. Again, completely subjective. Poking him for getting on the platform? Oh, I think that was actually really smart angling on Utopian's part, because of the fact that the dare wasn't able to connect in time because he angled it more into the stage rather than up above to the ledge. Because if he do it up to the ledge, then that dare would have connected. Basically, just like, woo! Right into the ledge and right into her divine toes. right into her feet. Yeah, clean stuff from Jen. He's pumped. He feels good. They're both shooting tons of motion. They're getting ready. And surprisingly, he's still staying Rosa. Yeah, I guess that's me is counter pick against Palu. And we're going Lilac. Alright. Rosa's got the space advantage, dude. Yo, Mario Galaxy 3 looking kinda nice right now, I gotta admit. But jokes aside, I'm very surprised to see this stage pick. I'm generally surprised it's still a counter pick, as you know, but here we are. I'm not the one to question at this point. I'm not sure who his benefits, though. And also, I'm not sure who even chose it, as well. Well, actually, not thinking about it, I guess, Jen must have. Wait, no, Utopia must have, I mean to say. Right, okay. Remember that, I saw this clip going around Twitter with Rosa not being able to snap ledge. Yeah, it was against, it was with the Buzz at Costa California's. Right, right. So he tried to up B onto the ledge on the left side where Utopia just was, and she just fell through the ledge. So I don't know why Utopian's even bothering with Lilac, because I feel like that's a huge risk, trying to recover with a recovery like hers. But obviously he had some good intent in mind. He has an idea for why he wanted to go Lilac at the very least. Or maybe he's wanting to try to limit Palutena's options slightly, because I'm sure doing teleportation recoveries can be a little iffy with platforms like these as well. But honestly, I wouldn't know. I only know really much about Unova, Jank, in terms of platform, in terms of teleportation recoveries. Oh, and another jab, actually gonna kill this time. Luma's surprisingly powerful, man. Oh, but also Luma's dead. So, like, she's powerful, but very, very small amount of health. Like, think of projectiles or other objects that aren't characters to have some form of health. Like, missiles from Samus, Luma, they all have different amounts of health. Phantom, if you will, the big homie from Zelda, she also has a kind of health pool. So if you do enough damage onto those projectiles or items, if you will, whatever you want to call it, then they'll just break apart, they'll disappear, they'll die, essentially. And that shield poke from the up tilt, he's getting so many kills with up tilt. It's crazy. I've never seen up tilt used this much before from Palutena. And working this effectively. Oh, and covering the neutral tech with a double up air, converting into a back air, pushing Luma off stage. The stage control on both fronts, like, he's controlling Luma, he's controlling Rosa. It's really, really aggressive and dominating from Jet. Same time though, Tobin's got the good punishes on the parries, pushing her away. Because it seems like Rosa didn't do too well up close against against Palutena. Unless you're able to punish her for going ham on shield like that with Nair. Getting that slick forward tilt and pushing her away. Covering an air dodge with a Nair. Oh, I even confirmed it to up air, surprisingly. I never knew. I never knew that was actually a thing. Oh, setting up a Luma, punishing the ledge get up, and another Luma jab will seal the deal for that stock. Maybe he wanted Lilac because of the fact that the blast zones are smaller on the sides. That could be why. Considering the fact that, again, he is. Wait, oh my gosh. See that? Why didn't he stab ledge? Unless he held down on that to go over the ledge for some reason. That was really odd. But lucky for him, he didn't get punished too heartily for that. But yeah, maybe he wanted, wow, get up tilt. What the hell is up tilt, bro? maybe he definitely wanted the stage this way he killed earlier with Luma. Luma's bugging, man. Luma's scared. Whenever Rosa gets hit, Luma just goes into a frenzy. She panics. Oh no! And Luma's gone. Unfortunate. And she almost got the air dodge perfectly, but just a little too late on the down air. Alright. Just push her away with the back throw. But she's able to come back pretty easily as well. Good damage because of a jump with the up throw. But there's no jump on Rosa right now, and she was dead. Yep. Yep, again, like, from that Nair, she had no jump, and thus, she was pushed off into a really bad safety advantage off stage, and from there, the back air sealed the deal, and thus, took the game and the kill, as well as the set. Jen moving on to, I believe, where's finals?